Hello friends, this is Anil from BloggersPassion.com. In today's video, we are going to talk about how to improve the speed for your WordPress-based websites and blogs. There are three things we are going to talk about in today's video. One, why we need fast loading website. Second, how to check the speed for any website. And the third, how we can improve speed for WordPress-based websites and blogs. So first of all, let's talk about why we need fast loading websites. Fast loading websites helps with conversions. If you want to improve conversions for your websites, you should aim at improving the speed for your website. If you ask any conversion optimizing expert, they would also suggest you to improve the speed for your website if it's loading really slow. So most of your website pages should load within a couple of seconds. If they are taking more than that time, you are losing lots of money on the table. So if you want more conversions from your existing traffic, you should aim at improving the speed for your important pages at least. Then Google also give more weightage to the websites that are loading really fast. Some time back, Google come up with an algo update where it says it will rank those websites higher which are loading really fast. So if your website is loading slower than your competitor websites, Google is going to show your website pages below your competitor websites. So if you want to outrank your competitor websites for your targeted terms, you should aim at bringing website traffic better than your competitor websites. Another reason to improve speed is for better user experience. No one loves to visit a website that's taking lots of time in loading. If your website is taking more than 5 to 6 seconds, lots of people will abandon that and will move to the next website. If they are doing that, so you will be losing lots of traffic and revenue. When someone will visit your website and if they see it's taking lots of time, they will just close your website and move to your competitor websites. That will have downside to your engagement matrices like bounce rate, page views per visit, time spent, etc. So if you want to have better engagement matrices, you should work on improving your website speed. So you should improve your website speed if you want more conversions, if you want more traffic from Google search, and if you want to have better experience for your users, you should improve your website speed. So these were three important reasons due to which you should look at improving the speed for your website. Now, second, let's talk about how you can check your website speed on different devices and for different landing pages and for different locations. So there are lots of tools you can use to check the speed for website pages. So the first tool that I'm going to use to test the speed for any website is called ping dom tool. So I'll just go to ping dom tools. Let me check the speed for my blog homepage, and from here I can pick the location of my choice and then I'll just click on the start test. Let's wait for a few seconds. So the results for my blog homepage are here. So my blog homepage is taking 8 to 5 milliseconds, which is even less than a second. The total page size is 699 KB. Total requests are 41. And the grade that's given to homepage is 92 out of 100, so which is really amazing. Let me try one more tool. Let's try Google page speed tool. Now here I'm going to enter my blog homepage and click on analyze. It's going to take some time. Now we have the results. If you look at my blog homepage speed on mobile, that's 72 out of 100, which looks okay. And for desktop, it's 88 out of 100, which is fine. So I need to work to improve my blog homepage speed on mobile specifically. If you spend some time going through the recommendation that Google has made, you can find lots of action elements on the basis of which you'll be able to improve the speed for your website. So you can use ping dom or Google page speed tool or even GT metrics to check the speed for any of website home page or internal pages and work on the pages which are taking more than 2 to 3 seconds in loading. Now let's talk about the third part, which is about what needs to be done to improve the speed for WordPress based websites and blogs. First of all, you should buy a hosting which is really fast. If you can afford, you should go for a fast loading hosting. We have been using WPX hosting on BloggersPassion more than 3 years now. It's really fast and their support team is also really friendly. WPX hosting will cost you around $20 for a month. So you should go for WPX hosting if you have some budget for hosting, and if you have limited budget, you can go for Bluehost or SiteGround hosting. So the first thing you can do to get better speed for your website is invest more money in hosting. You should go for a host which takes very less time in loading your website pages. Next, you should use a caching plugin on your WordPress based websites. Caching plugins creates a temporary document containing your HTML and images, etc. So when you use a caching plugin, it will help in improving the speed for your website. There are lots of caching plugins available. If you have the budget, you can go for WP Rocket caching plugin, which we are using on BloggersPassion as well. And if you don't have much budget, you can go for free caching plugins like W3 Total Cache or WP Super Cache. Next, you should use a plugin which can optimize your images. When you are uploading any image on your blog, you should optimize them first and then upload them. You should not use too big size images on your blog. And when you have uploaded some images, there are lots of plugins which can help in improving the size of those images further. On BloggersPassion, we are using ShortPixels image optimization plugin. It's a premium plugin. There are lots of options available with this plugin. You can use lazy loading and can change the format for your images and can also optimize the images as per your choice. Apart from ShortPixels, there are lots of other image optimization plugins available. You can use Imageify, which is a free image optimization plugin, or you can also use Smashit plugin. Next, you should use a CDN on your blog. What is a CDN? CDN is a content delivery network. It will serve your website pages from the server location which is nearest to it. So a CDN will have its servers in different locations. So they will serve your website data from their own servers, which is very closest to your current location. In that case, data will not travel much, so it will be served from the location which will be very closest to your location. There are lots of CDNs available. If you are looking for free options, you can use Cloudflare, and we are using WPX hosting, so they have their own CDN, which is WPX Cloud. If you are using any other host, you can just talk to your host and ask about the CDN. So they could have their own CDN, or maybe they can integrate Cloudflare CDN for you. Now, what else you can do to improve the speed for your WordPress-based websites? You should optimize your databases from time to time. There are lots of plugins available you can use to optimize your databases. There is a plugin called WP Optimize, which will optimize your databases, then clean up lots of extra files which are created due to post revisions or spam comments or pingbacks or many other things. So you should use this plugin from time to time. Next, you should get rid of extra themes and plugins. You should just keep those plugins and themes on your WordPress dashboard which you are using. There is no point of keeping those plugins active which you are not using. You should just remove them from your dashboard. Visit your WordPress dashboard and go through the WordPress plugins section. Just keep those plugins active which you really need and delete all other plugins which you are not using right now. You should use the updated version for all the themes and plugins that are installed on your blog. So these were few things that you can do to improve the speed for your WordPress site, even if you don't know anything about coding. So in today's video, I did not talk about any method or any technique for which you need to add any code in your WordPress blog. We just talk about certain plugins which can help in improving the speed for your WordPress sites. Friends, in case you are liking my videos, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my YouTube channel. I'll keep coming with more interesting videos around blogging and SEO related topics. So till then, keep watching the videos on my YouTube channel and we'll see you in the next video.